ओम श्री गणेशाय नमः, ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः, ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः, ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं। ओम सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनापधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम। इन आवर अर्लियर क्लास वी डिस्कवर फोर पॉइंट्स अबाउट God, Brahman. That one, that Brahman is the cause of all, and therefore he pervades all. It is all, and it is beyond all. Also, we understood that we are the part of the Virat cosmic form, and therefore, if we remain in tune with that cosmic form, all the resources of the cosmic form are available to us, then we are not limited and finite. But if we identify only with our limited body and look at ourselves only as an individual, then always we'll remain finite little, you know. One more thing will happen, that when we understand that even all beings are also part of the same, then our way of looking at our other people also will be different. And that's what we have to gain. But now when it is said, sarvata panipadam tat sarvatokshi shiromukham, that it has got hands and legs everywhere and all that, so we think that we have got hands and legs, and how problematic it is. So it must be a great problem for Bhagwan, you know. So we are always worried. We worry about God also. So that's a very nice thing that we are sympathetic to God. But Bhagwan says, that is very nice of you to think about me, but the truth is what? सर्वेन्द्रियगुणाभासं सर्वेन्द्रियविवर्जितं सर्वस्य प्रभुमीशानं सर्वस्य शरणं सुहृत। There is Suhrut also is reading there, but actually Heti says sarvasya sharanam brihat. Brihat. Some place Suhrut also is said, but brihat. Now the first line of this mantra is again also familiar, because that is also said in the 19th chapter of the Gita. What did I say? What chapter I say? No, 19th. Oh, but there is no 19th chapter only. So it is only the 13th chapter of the Gita. Sarvata panipadam tat sarvatokshi shiromukham, it is said. And then he says, sarvendriya gunabhasam sarvendriya vivarjitam. This Paramatma is what? Sarva indriya gunabhasam. It appears according to the qualities and properties of all senses, but sarvendriya vivarjitam, but itself is totally free from all the upadhis and their qualities and their activities, their functions. Sarvendriya vivarjitam. Now see, look at ourselves subjectively also, you see, this I, the consciousness. When it is functioning through the eyes, then I say, I am seeing. Then through the ears, I say, I am hearing. And I am through the nose, I am smelling. So then I become a seer here, but if I look at myself as I alone, without any association with it, then am I a perceiver, feeler, thinker, doer, enjoyer? Can I be called that? No. So with whichever upadhi I am identified or functioning through or expressing myself, then that type of what you call the designation comes to me. But otherwise, if I look at myself, then I am free from all that. Correct? So here this Paramatma is like that. On one hand, sarvata pani padam tad, and then it is appearing in all that. But sarvendriya gunabhasam, sarvendriya vivarjitam. Also, you know, the example in the outside world, you know, the electricity's example also is very beautiful. Because when it is expressing through the bulb, it appears as light. And through the fan as a movement. And now through this amplifier, you know what it is. So different. In the refrigerator, so you find the whole cooling, or the way heating. But if you look at the electricity as power, it is free from all those. But whichever equipment it is functioning, then according to that quality it appears. And this Lord is what? Sarvasya Prabhu Mishanam. Sarvasya Prabhu. Already I told you, Prabhu is Sarvasamartha, omnipotent, all capable, and that is the Lord of all. Ishanam, the ruler. Sarvasya Prabhu Mishanam and Sarvasya Sharanam Bruhat. Bruhat, it is infinite, limitless, place of shelter. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. So Sharanam, what is Sharanam? Bhagwan. Bhagwan is our refuge. Shelter. If you are walking in the hot sun, you look for a shelter, you know, some shade somewhere, you know, it may be of a tin shed, or it may be of a tree, or it may be a house, so then it gets an ashraya sthan, you know. Otherwise, it's scorching heat and all that, you know. Yeah? Come say, come umbrella, you hold. That also sharan. Or if it is rains, then also. So sharan is called arti haranasthanam, is called sharanam. The place of the removal of our distress, that's called sharanam. Now, from the absolute standpoint, if someone realizes this Brahman as his own or her own nature, so then you become one with that. So there is what? Adi bhut, adi daiva, adhyatma, nothing is there then. So there is no distress at all. There is no stress and there is no distress. Both are not there. As an individual, when we act here in this world, as a jiva, because here in the world we have to act only as an individual. Even a jnani purusha also will have to act only as an individual. At that time, the total Virat Roop Paramatma is our Sharanam. So then any kind of problem is there. So that is, Bhagwan is there, you know. And as an individual, we always have got some kind of, you know, you call a situation, you call some difficulties. And, you know, in this part of the world, they use the one word. I have some issues. Some issues are there. Oh, issues. Some health issues are there. Some wealth issues are also there. Some financial issues are there. Then some issues, you know, I can't talk about, you know. So we know what it is. That is the third issue. You know. You know, some family issues are there. So there's always some one or the other kind of. Now, where will you do all that? You see, there is no use of telling our problems to people, you know. I read a very beautiful quotation. Don't tell your problems to people, because 80% of them don't care and 20% are happy you have problems. So don't tell people. If at all you want to tell, Bhagwan ko batao, zara kuch fayda hai. If at all anything is there, you tell Bhagwan. Sharanam, only the Bruhat Sharanam. And that Sharanam Bhagwan is such a Bruhat. Any number of people can seek refuge in him at one and the same time. In the world, even if someone is there, that's very, very sympathetic, helpful and all that, but that person cannot help everybody and all that. But Bhagwan is Bruhat. And there is another reading called Suhrut also. So Suhrut means a well-wisher. Because our that place of refuge must be well-wisher. And without expecting anything in return, that is called Suhrut. Pratyupakaram anapeksha upakara karta is called Suhrut. Without expecting anything in return, the one who wishes good for us and does good for us is called Suhrut. So Bhagwan is Suhrut also, Bhagwan is Bruhat also. So any number of people can go at one at the same time also. So from the absolute standpoint, if you realize Brahman is my nature, so that I little individual only disappears. So there is no problem of any kind. But even as an individual, when we live here, we may be having some difficulties, we may be having some problems or whatever is that you call. And then if you find that in this world is nobody is able to really help, but Lord is there. That's the Sharanam Bruhat. Sarvendriya guna bhasam, sarvendriya vivarjitam, sarvasya prabhumi shanam, sarvasya sharanam bruhat. Okay. Now, that Paramatma only is present in the hearts of all beings as what we call as I. It is that Lord alone is there in the heart of all beings as the Jiva. Here it says, Navadvare Pure Dehi.
Navadvare Pure Dehi.
Hamso Lelayate Bahi.
Hamso Lelayate Bahi.
Vashi Sarvasya Lokasya.
Vashi Sarvasya Lokasya.
Sthavarasya Charasya Cha. And that Bhagwan's presence is there here, Navadvare Pure, in the town, in the city of nine gates. Now, what is a Pura? What is a town? What do you call a town? Suppose there is only one road there. Can it be called a town? It is only a road. And only few houses are there, then also it is not called a town. Puram means Puryate. अनेकैः वस्तुभिः पदार्थैः पुरुषैः स्त्रीभिः भवनैः देन दैट इज कॉल्ड पुरम विच इज फिल्ड विथ मेनी थिंग्स रोड्स मस्ट बी देयर देन हाउसेस मस्ट बी देयर दिस इज द रेसिडेंशियल प्लेस दिस इज अ बिजनेस प्लेस दिस इज अ गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसेस प्लेस दैट इज देयर द एंटरटेनमेंट प्लेस दैट इज देयर हॉस्पिटल ऑल्सो देयर एंड वन जेल ऑल्सो देयर and all kinds of amusement park also there, and depends upon the size of the town and all that. And then where all the schools there, college there, then we say it's a town. A small town, big cities and metropolitan city and cosmopolitan city and all that. Then the size. But all these things should be there. Otherwise there is just one place, only four houses are there. What will you do there? But the village of four houses, they decided to have a newspaper of their own village. Now what is there, you know, why? Only if you shout at each other's house, everybody knows what is there. But they thought, you know, we should have a newspaper. And so they brought out a newspaper and there was no news. So they used to have the crossword puzzle on the front page. Yeah. I must admire those people, you know, of that place, you know, that they thought of having that. So anyway, Puram means where all these things are, that's called Puram. And now here, Navadwarapura, in olden days, when there's a king, Raja, Maharaja and all that, the fortresses used to be there, and there used to be so many gates there. So during daytime they were open, and the other night time they used to close it, all that. Our body is called this Navadwarapuram. In this town, because just as the outside town is full with so many things and beings and houses and business places and all that, our this body also is full of, earlier we are saying, you know, ashtakam, dhatu ashtakam. We saw, you know, and if you look at the body, the head, trunk and shoulder and all that is one thing. But there are all the bones are there, flesh there and marrow there, blood there, you know. It is full with all those kind of ingredients and all that. That's why it is called Puram. Saptadhatu vihi Puranam. Achha. Then, here also gates are there. Nine gates are there because the outside world is entering into us. Two eyes, two nostrils, two ears and one mouth. How many are there? Seven are there, you know, two, seven here. Then one is called the genital organ, I'll call anus, nine are there. Some place they say 10, some places they say 11, but generally famous is nine, city of nine gates. The 10, sometimes they will point out the navel also, and then 11th is here the crown of the head, here crown of the head. Close generally, only some yogis come out of that. Baki dusre ke liye jagah nahi hai usko. Ekadasha dwaram, ajasya avakrachetasa. So that is 11 also they point out, but commonly 9 are there. So, Navadware Pure Dehi. Dehi means Dehadhari, the embodied one. So, that Purusha, even though is all pervading, but now it has assumed this body. And that Dehi is called Hamsaha. Hamsa word, already we have discussed that. Hamsa here means Hamsaha Gachati. That's called Hamsa. This Jiva is living here in this. That's called Hamsaha. And Hamsa Lelayate. Lelayate. Lelayate means moves. Moves means acts. You know, perceives the world, then responds, and then decides on actions, and then reactions, then interaction and counteractions, and so many things are that Hamsa Pakshi is doing. The Jiva. Udu jayega hamsa akela. And then one day that hamsa akela udu jayega. Jagado din ka mela. Since it's all jagat. But that hamsa gachati. So that Chaitanya Paramatma only, with these individual upadhis, and then here is in the heart, it's called the Jivaha, Hamsa Lelayate, and Bahihi, and outward. And moves outward also. It's not only just shackled here and bowed here only. So he sees the outside world. And then he responds to all those things that are there. And he sometimes becomes very outward, outgoing also, extrovert. And all the time, are you not going for some sightseeing? Going out? No. But I am going out. Why? Eating out. Nowadays everybody is eating out. They don't like any food at their house and all that. Eating out. One day the husband told his wife, let us go for eating out. The wife said, what do you mean by you think I am tired of cooking or what? I am not tired of cooking. He said, you are not tired of cooking, but I am tired of washing. So you go out, for work, you go out for eating, you go out for sightseeing, go out for this hamsa goes on here, there. Navadware pure dehi hamso lelayate bahihi. And as a jiva, he remains only limited. But the jiva is essentially one with that Ishvara, and therefore as Ishvara, Vashi, Vasham Sarvam Vartate Asya, Iti Vashi, the one who keeps everything under its control, is the Lord, the Master, Vashi, Sarvasya Lokasya, Sthavarasya Characharasya. See, here actually saw Tattvamasi Mahavakyas are only pointed out, that Chaitanya Brahma, only functioning through one physical body, then he is called as Jiva. But the same Paramatma, through the totality, he is Sarvasya Lokasya, Characharasya, he is the Lord. So that Chaitanya Brahma only is appearing as Jiva, and the same is appearing as Ishvara also. So in the first line, Jiva Rupa is pointed out. Second is Ishvara Rupa is pointed out. Navadvare pure dehi hamso lelayate bahihi vashi sarvasya lokasya sthavarasya charasya cha. He is the Lord of the entire world, that which is moving and not moving. Sthavara, not moving. Chara, moving. All the things and beings and all that. Now interesting, earlier it was said sarvata pani padam tat, and now suddenly it is said he has no hands, no legs. What happened? Amputated? What happened? Now next mantra you see, apani pado javano grahita. पश्यत्य चक्षुस्स श्रुणोत्य कर्णः सवेत्ति वेद्यं न च तस्यास्ति वेत्ता तमाहुरग्र्यं पुरुषं महान्तम्. Now this Purusha about whom we are seeing, apani padaha, he is without hands and without legs. Pani means hands, pada means legs. Without hands and legs, but javanaha, very fast. Without legs, and he runs very fast. And no hands, but grahita, but he catches. Catches, seizes, holds everything. Pashyati achakshu, eyesless, has no eyes, but sees, without eyes sees. Sashrunoti akarnaha, and listen, even though without eyes, but he listens. Savetti vedyam, and it is this Paramatma knows everything. Nachata syasti vetta, but nobody knows him. He is a knower of all, but nobody knows him. Tam ahuragrim purusham mahantam. That reality is Ahu, the great rishi's call, is mahantam purusha, mahan purusha, and agrim, the primordial being, the first being, self-existing being. Again, you know now, those people who have no guidance of teacher, and only suppose they have got only the knowledge of Sanskrit grammar and dictionary. And if they see that earlier it was a sarvata pani padam, everywhere hands, legs. Now it is said no hands, no legs. Paramatma hai kya? I really want to know that. You know, when you go on telling like that, sometimes I have doubt whether anything exists also like that or not. Or you are taking us on a ride, or for a ride, not on a ride, but for a ride. I don't know what you are doing. Please tell whether he has hands and legs or he doesn't have. Tell me one thing, you know. Both are true. He has also and he doesn't have also. Now what is this? Now see, the one reason of using this kind of language is very important. They call paradoxical language, paradoxical. You know why? Because for us, knowing means objectifying. When we say, I know something, what do I mean by I know something? Something becomes an object of my perception, or mind, or intellect. So something I understand as a very gross material form. The table and chair and the fruits and vegetables and this and flower. Yeah, I know. But as love, kindness, compassion, no, they are not like table, chair and all that, but they are emotions and feelings. Yes, I understand that. I understand what is love, which I want from everybody, but I don't give to anybody. That's called love. So as emotions I understand. Then I'm a physicist and scientist and all that. So I know all the concepts of the physics and other. Oh. Okay. So then again it is something object of the intellect, you see. We understand that. In other words, we have got that this kind of knowledge, and anything something is said we are not able to understand, then we have got our own tendency of making our own concept then. Isn't it? When we don't understand something, and we cannot remain without forming some concept, all that. So then we have our own imagination also. And this is particularly true with God, about God. That every individual has, nobody knows what that God is, but then everybody has got some concept of God, some image. Somebody say it is not there, even that also is a concept. They don't realize that it is not there, that also you have only formed one some idea about it, which may not be true. Even when we say God is infinite, now what is infinite we never understand, but we think infinite. Gagana sadrusham. Gagana is like this sky and this way. Understood. What understood? See, again you have some form, some concept, what you call as formless. But I tell you, when someone says, it is not there, that is one concept. It is there, another concept. And it is like this, it is like that, that also is a concept. Upanishads use this kind of language and technique just to see that you do not form any concept. Because anything that you've concept, then you are limiting it. That's why they say God defined is God defiled. That means if you define that God in a particular way, then you are limiting it. So the moment one word is used, we have got one idea. So they just say the opposite of it. They remove that. When all concepts, everything is gone, then whatever is, that is. Don't ask again what it is. Because if you ask again, there's some definition will come there. That is one meaning. So once it is said, it has got hands and legs everywhere, then you say it has no hands and legs. And better said, has no hands and legs, but goes very fast and takes everything and all that. What is the meaning? So the other thing is, all these descriptions which seem to be contradictory, these statements are made from different standpoints. One is they don't allow us to make any kind of kalpana, idea or concept. Don't want to you have to catch that Bhagwan in some idea only. And other thing is, these are the two descriptions from two standpoints. Like, you know, in Dadru Bhade, Asino Duram Rajati. Sitting goes far. Now, a sitting, how can you go far? So then it is said, one indication is sopadhik and other is nirupadhik. Means one is in association with some conditioning and the one is without any conditioning. One is from its own standpoint and the other is from the other standpoint is perceived. Now you see, we see moon is waxing and waning, right? But does it wax and wane? Is it goes on, moon goes on reducing, dark. Then again it starts growing. And they are thinking that we can build some colonies there and we can stay also there and all that. But if it goes on reducing, what will happen to all the people there were who go? So obviously it is not so. But we say, so then it is two contradictory things are not. Full moon, moon is always full only. Whatever it is full. Now but standing on the earth what we experience, then we say waxing, waning. The same thing with the sun also rising and setting. So they, from one standpoint, the sun rises at this time, sun sets at this time. But sun does not rise. Now which is right? But then we don't know both are right. When we say this, there is no rise and setting, then that is from the standpoint of the sun as it is. There is no rise and setting. And when we say it rises at this time and like that, that is our standpoint. So it is said, apani pada, no hands, no legs. It is from its own standpoint. It is without all that. But with the upadhi, that alone is manifesting. Just as this electricity is a bulb, a fan, a refrigerator, a heater. There is no in that electricity, if you look at it, where is the heater? And there is no microwave. There is nothing that is there. But you know, it is only heating it so fast. Without that heater, but it is only heating. Without bulb, it is only lighting. Clear? So therefore it is said, apani pado javano grahita pashyatya chakshusa shunotya karanaha savetti vedyam nachatasyasti vetta. And now when it says savetti vedyam nachatasyasti vetta, it is a knower of everything, but nothing knows it. That means what? It is the subject, not an object. And subject only will know the object. Object will not know the subject. Right? My eyes will see the wristwatch. But can the wristwatch see the eyes? Even if 1 hour you keep like that. Or what are you trying? Now I am trying to see my eyes with this watch. Now you watch for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. But every time you will see only the watch. Because this is an object, this is a subject. Object cannot know the subject. So here says, Bhagavan is that the consciousness, the subject. Natu drishyate, never become drishyavastu. Therefore it is a savetti vedyam nachatasyasti vetta tamahuragrim purusham mahantam. And that is mahan purusha agrim. Agrim means that is the first being. From that only everything has come. That is called agrim purusham. Tamahuragrim purusham mahantam. apani pado javano grahita. This type of mantra is there in where? In Kaivalya Upanishad we find that. And now let us see, where do you find the next mantra? Anoraniyan mahato mahiyan. आत्मा गुहायां निहोतस्य जन्तो तमक्रतुं पश्यति वीतशोको धातु प्रसादान महिमानमीशम्. They change some word here and there, you know. And because we are used to chanting something in one way, so we say anoraniyan mahato. So we immediately chant like as whatever is known to us. Anoraniyan mahato maya atma sejanto. It changed that word, sir. Atma guhayam nito sejanto. This atma is what? Ano ho aniyan, subtler than an atom, subtler than subtle anything you can imagine. And mahato mahiyan, and it is bigger than the biggest. And this atma is where janto ho guhayam nihitaha. It is there in the cave, not outside cave. Janto ho, abhi jantu, we are all jantus. I don't like to, you are calling me jantu. Because little worms and insects, and they are also called jantus, you know, creatures. So what else we are? Jantu. The Gita also said, adhyanena avrutam jnanam tena muhyanti jantavaha. Then we are jantu. We are also creatures only, you know. Because jantu means what? That which is born. Jan, janma, janma hua hai. Aur tano hoti, usko badhte bhi jata hai. Isliye, it's called jantu. Anyway, jivas. Haan, jiva you call it, but that is better. Don't call me jantu. This atma is there in the cave of the heart of all the jivas. It is subtler than the subtle and bigger than the biggest. Anoraniyan mahato mahiyan. Atma guhayam nihitosya jantoho tam akratum pashyati. Now there is a tam akratuhu pashyati. There akratu becomes the visheshan of this year. Now here akratu is called, atma is akratum. Tam akratum pashyati. And a wise person, a seeker, sees this atma. And what is that atma? Akratu. Kratu in Sanskrit means sankalpa. That which is free from all kinds of thought modifications. That is called. Sometimes kratu is also called yadne yaga. The karmas are also called kratu. So it is said, tam akratu means it is free from all mental modifications or any kinds of actions. That atma is like that. Now, a person, a seeker, pashyati tam atmanam. And some seeker is able to see this atma. But how do they see it? Dhatu prasadat. It is because of dhatu prasad. What is called dhatu prasad? You know, one dhatu prasad is the purity of mind. Dhatu means what? That which sustains is called dhatu. I think the metals or the elements, and they are also called dhatus, right? But here, dhatu actually sustains. Here, dhatu is nothing but our mind intellect. Prasad means purity. Purity of mind. And there is another beautiful meaning is dhatuhu prasada. Dhatu is shashti vibhakti of dhata. Dhatu means by God's grace. Very, very nice it is. So if a seeker prays to God, one hand his mind is purified and God's grace also comes to that person. as a result of the purity of mind and God's grace, then this person is able to see Mahimanam Isham, the great glory of Paramatma, the Lord, and he sees in his own heart. And then what happens? When he says, Vita Shokaha, then he becomes totally free from all grief. Whether the grief, there's sorrow caused by surroundings, or caused by phenomenal forces, or caused by his own self, whichever way all the sorrows come, becomes free from that. Vita means what? Completely gone. That's called Vita. Visheshena Ita Shoka. That's called Vita Shoka. Anoraniyan Mahato Mahiyan. Now see, this comes, you know, this expression has come around. Subtler than the subtlest and bigger than the biggest. That means one meaning is it is infinite, it is out of all, all pervading. But also it means anoho aniyan, subtler than the subtlest, what is there? Tell me. As subjectively, if you see, the body is gross. With reference to body, the pranas are subtler. As compared with the pranas, the mind is subtler. With compared to the mind, or intellect is subtler. And with compared to the intellect, the subtler is what? The Chaitanya. Aham, 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 atma. That is subtlest. That's called the subtlest. So hereby saying the anoraniyan, it is inner self, that's what is indicated. And we say mahato mahiyan, bigger than the biggest, that means it is the very support of this external world. It is the adhishthan of this world. So when you say it's the greater than the greatest, so the support has to be the greater than the greatest, then only, you know. So therefore it is a mahato mahiyan means it is a substratum. Anoraniyan means it is the atma, it is the illuminator. Anoraniyan, mahato mahiyan, and this atma is there in the hearts of all beings and free from all activities, free from all mental modifications. And by its grace, then what happens? A person is able to realize it. And when that realization takes place, shoka gone. Tatrako mohaka shokaha ekatvam anupashyataha. And the one who sees the oneness of the substratum and the illuminator, then where is the moha, where is the delusion, and where is the grief? There is no grief possible. And the one who sees that atma, how he says that I see this. Earlier we have seen the similar mantra, you know. Vedahametam purusham mahantam adityavarnam tamasap parastat. Now here, again it is a statement of realization. Vedahametam ajaram puranam. Sarvatmanam sarvagatam vibhutvat. Janma nirodham pravadanti yasya. Brahmavadino hi pravadanti nityam. And now just now you say, dhatu prasadat. By God's grace that person sees this. And how he sees and realizes, Veda aham etam. I directly know this Atman. And how it is? Ajaram. Ajaram means ageless. There is no aging. Puranam. Puranam means ancient. Means eternal. Timeless. You see, that something which is bound by time cannot remain without the process of aging. Something created in time, it will have got to wear and tear if it is material things. And if it, we are talking about the living beings and all that, they also do not remain the same. See, the longevity is there, you know. How much? Like the medicine also, when you buy, there is a manufacturing date, there is expiry date also there, right? Even the milk also, you brought that packet, they say. And when they say they finish this before this, exactly next day it will be terrible. So because they have got the date of expiry date also. And also there's people who want to have, there is life insurance, this, that insurance, you know. They also have to get doctor certificate, you know. Expectant life, you know, how much it is. Expectant. One doctor gave very nice certificate. You will live as long as your heart works. Very nice. So there, this everywhere that how long, whatever that. So there is, because time bound. You know, when you invite somebody, you know, for a lecture, that man first he asks when it will end. Ajaram. So there is an aging process. Whatever is time bound, there will be aging and there will be perishing. But this Atmatattva I directly know, Ajaram and Puranam, Sarvatmanam. And it is not only myself only, but it is the self of all beings, Sarvatmanam. It is the self of all beings. Sarvagatam, it is all-pervading. And Vibhutvat, and being all-pervading, Pravadanti, Brahmavadinaha, about it, the great knowers of Brahman, they say that this Atma is free from Janma Nirodham Pravadanti, that it has no birth at all. Yasya, and Nityam, it is Nityam eternal. So by Janma Nirodham, it is pointed out, it is free from birth. Nityam, it is free from death. Ajaram is free from old age, all wear tear. And Puranam, Purana word is very beautiful. One meaning is ancient, but Puranam is which is ever new. Pura api navaha, even though ancient, but always new only. It never becomes old. What is called in the Bhagavad Gita's language? Ajo nityashashvato yam purano nahanyate hanyamane sharire. That is called ajo nityashashvato yam purano. This is the Atma now I realize. Now you see, when you say aham Atma and this, and I realize me, now if we just know only Shabdartha, we also can say I know. But the thing is, when the person comes to know that I am this Atma, free from birth and growth and disease and decay and death, then can we get worried about all the birth and disease and everything of the body? We don't say you don't take treatment, huh? Nobody says that. So because at the body level, all this will be there. So you take medical treatment. That's a different matter. But you know, worried. I am very worried. And they say, now I can't meditate. But actually, when we are not well, that's the best time for meditation. At that time, we should remember, Vedaham Etam Ajaram Puranam. Oh, all that is all right, you know, but when this pain in the body, it is difficult. No doubt it is difficult. Who says it is that? That's why so much of preparation is required, so much of purification is required, so much of practice is required, and so much of all that grace of God also required. When Vedanta says kshurasya dhara nishita duratyaya, that this Brahmajnana is like walking the razor. Brahmajnana is like walking the razor's edge. And then when we sit comfortably and study, what a difficult, it is so easy. What easy? Or taste to tabhi hoti hai phir. It's not very easy then. But that does not mean it is sorrowful or anything like that. But it is a great, great thing. One more mantra for this. Actually, third chapter is over. Now fourth chapter, only one more mantra. That much only time we have. Ya eko avarno.
Ya eko avarno.
Bahudha shakti yogat.
Bahudha shakti yogat.
Varnan anekan. Nihitartho dadhati. Vichaiti chante. Vishwamadav sadevaha. Sano buddhya shubhaya sanyunaktu. This is a great knowledge and requires constant reflection on that. And therefore, in so many ways, there is a reflection done, and the glory of the Lord, and glory of the Lord as our own Atma also is pointed out. Ya eko avarnaha, that which is one, one. And avarnaha, colorless. It is free from all kinds of colors. Colors means all properties should be understood. Huh? When we say varna, varna means not only just color, but all other properties you call physical properties, chemical properties, other emotional properties and so many properties. It is free from that. Avarnaha. But bahudha, shakti yogat, and shakti yogat because of association with this maya shakti, bahudha varnan anekan dadhati. But he manifests so many kinds of objects and colors and properties and what not, the variety. Nihitartha. This nihitartha is a very beautiful phrase actually. Nihitartha means in every object there is some meaning, some purpose that is placed there. Nihitartha. Nothing is purposeless. Nothing is useless here in this world. And that's why we know waste management itself is a science or not. What you call waste, waste product. But there is nothing waste. So you may not know what to do with it and all that, but nothing is waste. Nihitartha, one meaning is, in all that which is manifested, in everything there is some purpose. Everything, there is some meaning. And nihitartha, another meaning is, that's very beautiful. And what is that meaning is known only to God. He alone knows the purpose and the meaning of all that. Sometimes we may say, why this such and such thing is existing? That you may think why that such and such thing existing. But everything has got some purpose. Our body is constituted of so many factors. Do you think that everything that which is a meaningless? Nikal do aise, nikal do aise. No, everything has got a purpose. Now, just as one colorless beam of light passes through a prism and seven colors are manifested. So itself is colorless, but association with that prism, and then it manifests. It is one Paramatma through this Maya Shakti and all that, about which more will be said, and then it manifests in many forms. And everything has got some meaning in it. Vichaiti cha ante, and ante at the end, at the pralaya time, vieti. Vieti means it goes back to that Paramatma. Vishwamadav, in the beginning, that Vishwa which is created, in the end, again it goes back to him. Sa Devaha, that Deva. Sano buddhya shubhaya sanyunaktu. May that God bless us with what you call the noble thoughts, auspicious thoughts. You know about the purpose about that. It is there is a very beautiful shloka in Sanskrit, Subhashit that is there. In that it is said that amantram aksharam nasti. There is not a single sound which cannot become a mantra. Ka, ka, him, klim, rim. There is no sound which cannot become mantra. Amantram aksharam nasti. Nasti mulam anaushadham. And there is no what you call the herb or roots or your grass or anything which cannot become medicine. And ayogyaha purushaha nasti. And there is no useless incompetent person in this world. Only thing is difficult is yojakas tatra durlabhaha. It is only difficult to find a person who can understand their quality and make use of them. Every field, the sound is there. There is a mantra shastra there. The great rishis and all that, they meditated and understood the shabdas, aksharas, sound and mantras also came up. And any sound, any word also can become a mantra. And now in the present of the commercial world, any sound they use, any word they use, and that also become a slogan or not. Yes. In the same way, medicine, how much research is going on in different fields, and they find, oh, these are the medical properties are there. There such things are there, what we thought it was a useless thing, but no. It has this, it has that, everywhere, every day we hear that. And ayogya purushaha nasti. And what you call a physically challenged or other person, so now what they are calling is a differently able thing. Isn't it? They don't say it's useless or what you call the handicapped or anything. Such words also they don't allow us to use. Why? Because that person also can do things. He's capable. But when we do not know who is capable of what and putting him into wrong place and all that, naturally that person says he will not do. Because that is not his place at all. A mathematics teacher and one a music teacher was absent. Jo ja padha do mathematics. Or a mathematics. That does not. If he cannot teach music, does mean he is useless. But you are giving him a wrong subject. See, nihitartha word is very beautiful. Therefore, ye eko avarno. Bhauda Shakti Yogat Varnan Anikan Vidati Nihitartha. In every object there is some purpose is there, value is there, some quality is there. And who put it there? Bhagavan only. And therefore, we may not understand what is the purpose of this creation. We may not understand what is the purpose of this thing, that thing, that thing that is there, why they are there. But the Lord knows what is their purpose. So he is the creator, he is the sustainer, he is the dissolver. May that Bhagavan bless us with noble thought so that we understand that nothing is useless, but we should try to find out and make best use of. That's called Shubha Buddhi. Okay? I think we'll stop here now today. And we'll continue with a beautiful mantra. When it is said, Bahudha Shakti Yogat, what is the Shakti and how it is done, and all that we'll see in. Now let us sing the name of the Lord. Sometimes thinking also we get tired. what to do. Do you get tired? No, they can't say yes, you know, but Krishna, Krishna, Vasudeva, Krishna, Krishna, Vasudeva, Ektala. Narayana Deva Deva Narayana Narayana Deva Deva Krishna Krishna Vasudeva Krishna Krishna Vasudeva Krishna Narayana Deva Deva Narayana Krishna Krishna Vasudeva Govardhan Dhari Krishna Govardhan Dhari Krishna Vrindavan Chari Krishna Vrindavan Chari Krishna Bansidhar Bal Krishna Bansidhar Bal Krishna Radhavar Krishna Chandra Radha Radhavar Krishna Chandra Radhavar Krishna Chandra Got it. Krishna Krishna Vasudeva Krishna 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 Vasudeva Krishna Narayana Deva Deva Narayana Deva Deva Krishna Krishna Vasudeva Krishna Krishna Govardhan Dhari Krishna Govardhan Dhari Krishna Vrindavan Chari Krishna Vrindavan Chari Krishna Bansidhar Bal Krishna Bansidhar Bal Krishna Radhavar Krishna Chandra Radhavar Krishna Chandra Radhavar Krishna Chandra Radha Krishna Krishna Vasudeva Krishna 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 Vasudeva Nisi Radhavar Krishna Chandra Bhagavan Ki जय श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति 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 हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम।